Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2277, Wildcards in Excel VLOOKUP and SUMIFS. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jalen. Well, today I was in Minneapolis, Minnesota doing a seminar, and a great question came up. They said, you know, look, I have to look for these words. I think they were actually check numbers or something like that. But the field that I'm looking in has some text or numbers before the word and different text and numbers after the word. So I need to find, you know, like if fig is anywhere in there, I need to find the matching number. And I said, oh yeah, you know, this is not well known, but VLOOKUP will allow you to do wildcards, all right? And in this particular case, because there's stuff both before and after apple, we have to put an asterisk, an ampersand, apple, and then another ampersand and an asterisk in quotes like that, all right? So we're looking for anything, apple, anything. And we're going to look for it over here in this lookup table. Press F4, comma, 2, comma, false, like that. And double-click to copy it down. And it's finding the match, all right? Now, someone in the audience, Tim, said, well, hey, you're going to have a problem if you have both apple and crabapple. And that's true. You will. But, you know, so I guess it's not perfect. And then, I love how these questions evolve, right? So then I showed this, and someone said, oh, wait, would that work with SUMIFS? All right, so I created a copy of the data set, and this time have multiple items with apple, right? So we're looking for all of the words that have an apple anywhere in the middle, and we want to sum those, all right? So total, so equals SUMIFS, and the sum range, of course, is those numbers over there. I'll press F4, comma. And then the pairs of criteria, we want to look through all of these codes here to see if they're equal to asterisk, ampersand, apple, ampersand, asterisk, like that. All right, so add up the corresponding numbers from F if column E contains the word apple or banana or cherry or whatever. All right, so we'll double-click to enter that, and then double-click to copy that down. And I went and I found all the apples, and I brought them up here to the top. So if we choose these three cells here, 2664, and we get 2664, so it is working. All right, so a couple of cool little tricks there using wildcards, wildcard before and after what we're looking for, in order to find all of the things in the database that match apple. Well, hey, if you like what you see in these videos, don't forget to click subscribe and then ring that bell. If you have any questions or comments about how you've used wildcards or other great ways this will work, leave a comment down below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.